Hi, it's Liz from Sew for Home. You might be wondering why I'm wearing a coat inside. Well, it's a clever lead-in to a great project. This is a puffer coat, always a top choice for staying toasty. Also a style choice for fashion leaders from sports to Hollywood to the concert stage. But recently, we noticed this unique texture starting to show up in high-end handbags. Time to lead the pack, bringing a DIY version to you. Our puffer sling bag, top trend style, you can make yourself. So what is creating this cool puff? Two layers of ripstop nylon with a layer of high-loft polyester batting in between. We then use the Janome Continental M8 with its ASR accurate stitch regulator, ruler work foot, and a scallop template to quilt the front panel. After that, we switch to the M8's AccuFeed Flex built-in fabric feeding system with a standard dual feed foot to handle the straight line quilting around the bag as well as across the base. It really was the perfect combination. And even with these very lofty layers and, you know, ripstop's traditionally slippery surface, it was smooth and easy. It was almost like drawing on the fabric with thread. In fact, to emphasize this, we used the same color of thread in the top and the bobbin for both the front panel clamshells as well as the straight line quilting. And it really gave us a beautiful little bit of stitch art on the inside of the bag. If you haven't come across a stitch regulator before, in a nutshell, there's camera technology happening underneath, and its job is to keep consistent spacing between the stitches, resulting in smoother curves and more balanced stitches during your free motion work. Now, Janome's ASR is currently included on the CM17 and the M8, and is compatible as an option on the 9480. Now, if one of these models is not in your sewing space, at least not yet, you can get a similar look using standard free motion quilting with or without a ruler work foot and a template. As usual, we have done a lot of testing to figure out what the best options would be. And we decided on ripstop because it's the same type of nylon fabric used on classic puffer coats, and it comes in a huge variety of fantastic colors. Both the bag itself and its straps feature two colors, and we alternated them for the inside binding and around the top for some extra pops of contrasting color between the two. Now, there is nothing that can't be washed. The polyester batting is bonded and ripstop is naturally water repellent. So a simple machine wash on gentle and tumble dry on low is all you need. An inset base, which is also quilted, ensures the structure and helps make it easy to set down the bag without it tipping over. Now the main pieces are just rectangles that you will cut once your quilting is complete. But there is a free pattern download for the shoulder strap so that you can get the perfect double flared ends. Its extra long fixed position means you can wear the bag over the shoulder, crossbody, or just grab and sling and off you go. The puffer bags we saw at high-end retailers, they all had a real sporty, kind of a casual vibe. So our DIY version is designed in the same mode. And it is soft enough to hug right up against your body and super lightweight. Part of that soft and light nature is because of our choice to not use any metal hardware. Simple skinny ties, they are optional, but they help bring together the top of the bag. As always, our thanks to Janome America for sponsoring this project. And if you are shopping for your next machine upgrade, take a look at the Continental M8 at your Janome dealer and get an in-person tour of the Accurate Stitch Regulator. I think you'll love it. So this project is free to you right now at Sew for Home. Thanks for listening, and happy sewing!